The day the world gets round to understand where it is. Using all that's found to help each other.
Hey folks, thanks for tuning in to the Judge Timbers channel. First, I want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving, of course, especially to my American friends. Please enjoy your turkey, enjoy your friends and your family. And we are very thankful in the Beatle world, the Beatle community, because the George Harrison Estate recently gave us a 50th anniversary edition of George's classic, Living in the Material World, his 1973 album. Of course, the song we're going to cover today comes from that album, The Day the World Gets Round. I've always loved this song. I always felt it was Beatle-level, George Harrison-caliber song. I always thought it should have been a longer song. And finally, on the 50th anniversary, we get a different take that is longer. So I love that. But again, I just think it's a fabulous song, and it really inspired. I never played the song until recently. This 50th edition inspired me to finally learn this song. And here it is. So I wanted to post this as kind of a special Thanksgiving edition of the Judge Timbers channel, because I'm so thankful for the new Living in Material World and, you know, rediscovering the song, but delving into the song in more detail. So let's get into it. A couple of things about this song. First, if you know the song, you know George plays what we call harmonics on the Day the World Gets Round part. It's not some of the technique I really use often, so I'm not going to try to teach harmonics. You know, harmonics just basically are, you just lightly kind of, you know, play strings and kind of lift off, that kind of thing. Again, I'm not going to even try to explain it. I'm not very good at it. So George does play with harmonics on this, so I'm sorry, you're going to have to watch somebody else or learn it yourself that way. The other thing, I think George may be using some open tunings, at least on some of the guitars in this. I do play with open tunings, but I'm not playing with one here. I really wanted to make this a very basic level, but, you know, sound level, to play this song by yourself on acoustic guitar in standard tuning without kind of any fancy tricks or techniques. So this is my arrangement, so please understand that this isn't exactly how George Harrison played it. But I will say, everything I teach you, you can play to the record in the key of the song and just have fun with it. As I always say, play it your own way, play it within your abilities, have fun with this. This is a great song to sing, so I'm thinking more about the lyrics and the singing than I am the guitar a little bit on a song like this. But it's a fun song to play too. So let's get into this. I am using a capo though on the second fret. So the song is in the key, hopefully you can see that there. The song is in key of E major. So I'm gonna play in a D shape with a capo on the second fret. So hopefully you understand that. A E chord would be like that. I'm sorry, I'm doing about the capo. An E chord would sound like that, right? And so with a capo, the D shape is going to sound basically the same. And if you listen to this recording, you could definitely tell at least some of the guitars, the 12 string and some of the other guitars, whatever George is playing on this, some, if not all, are capoed at least on the second fret. Maybe some are capoed higher. There's no doubt in my mind. Many capos are probably being used on this song. There might be a guitar in standard tuning playing in an E as well, but I'm not really hearing that. But anyway, my lesson, my way, is going to be capo on the second fret, and hopefully this will help you out. So let's get into the day the world gets part, the intro, the outro, and that part, what my adaptation for this. So again, this is a simplified way to play it. I think I've made it very easy so you can think about the words and how you want to sing it. So I'm going to break it into three little parts. The day, part one, the world, part two, gets round, right? So just to make it simple. And then we'll get right into the chords. So what I'm going to do for the first part, the day, so it's going to be, you know, the day, the day. So what I'm doing is playing a D major chord, just a D chord. It said it was in D with a capo. I'm going to pinch the 4 and 2 and the 3 and 1. So very easy. The day, the day. That's part one. Next part, I'm going to think of it. I like to think of chord shapes. I'm going to go to a D major 7, so a little bar there on the second fret with the capo. But all I'm going to play is really the 3 and 2 string, the G and B. So get the world. The world, the world. So just 3, 2, real easy. And then gets round, I'm going to play. Gets round. And that's just back to a D I'm going to play, but really all I'm playing is on the second string, the third fret. And then I'm pinching the 2 and the 4. Gets round. So let me show you how it sounds together. So part one, the day. Part two, the world. Part three, gets round. And then you play just 2 D notes, just on the 4th string open. So one more time, or let me see how it sounds. I'll do it in real time now. The day, the world, gets round. So one more time. So we're just gonna pinch 2 and 4 and 3 and 1. The day. And now the world, just 3, 2. The way the world gets round. Okay, so that's my adaptation for that part. Again, you could play it different ways. To understand. So first chord is an E7th sus4. Sounds a little difficult, but it's really easy to play. It's just a 2-finger chord, and you're just going to play on the second fret the 5 and the 3. I think it's really famous from California Dreamin', has a lot of E7th sus4. So you're going to start with that. To understand where it's been. Now you just go to an E7. So all you're doing is you're keeping the 5 at the 2, and on the second fret, the 3 is going down to the 3rd string, I'm sorry, 3rd string at the 2 is going down to the 1. So an E7. You know how to play an E7th, right? So again, 2 under E7, sus4, to an E7. Now you're going to hold the E7th. You're going to start playing that F sharp, which would be at the 4th fret. It's a bit of a stretch with your pinky there, at the 4th fret on the 4th string. Yeah, I got to look at this with the capo. So you're still playing the E7th, but you're, which the orchestra is playing too. Then to an A7th, to a G major. To a D major. And you could sus four whenever you want, right? So let's do that one more time. So again, we'll start it from the day the world gets round to understand E7 sus four to an E7. So again, we're gonna hold that, then just start adding that pinky riff. A7th.
Losing all that's found. Killing each G. Hand in hand.
So again, with that E7th. A7th. G. Really, you want to kind of emphasize the B note in the G chord.
Handy.
Now, such foolishness is the next part. So an A.
Foolishness in man G. I want no part D of the plan.
E7, sus 4 again.
Whoa, whoa.
A major. The next part, C, G, D, and you hold the D.
Cause I don't wanna be like you.
A. And then you're gonna do a D over A. Hopefully you know that. And then back to the C, G, D. Hold the D. Hold the D.
I don't wanna be like you.
A. Over A.
Bounce before you.
That's a G, C, G, G. Repeat it. C, G. And then you're in the G.
Oh, how we pray for the.
And then you're back to the.
The day the world gets round. To understand.
E7, sus 4. I'll do it one more time. E7. I'll call the chords. Now we're going to start that riff. A7.
All you found to help each G. Hand in hand.
D major.
Such a ness in man G. I want no D. Of the E7 sus 4. Whoa, A, C, G, D. Hold the D, hold the D. Cause I don't wanna be like an A. D over A, C, G, D. Hold the D, ooh, hold the D. Oh, back to A. D over A, G, C, G, G, C, G, G, and then you're back. The day the world gets round, D, D.
And if you want that little run before the orchestra, it's just on the D, the 4 open twice, and then at the 4th fret. And then at the third string at the 2nd fret. Sounds a lot nicer with the 12th string, but. Back to the E7th, sus 4. The E7th. So it's probably the hardest part, this little riff, little stretch. A7.
Losing all you found.
That's it, folks. That is my arrangement, the Judge Timbers arrangement for The Day the World Gets Round by George Harrison off Living in the Material World. Thank you, thank you, thank you to Danny and Olivia and the whole George Harrison estate for giving us this new release, this 50th anniversary edition. It's really wonderful. I highly recommend it if you haven't picked it up already. I have it there. You can see it in the background. It's great. And like I think I said, there's a longer version, kind of a demo, a take, an earlier take of this song, which I love because it's just longer and I love this song. So thanks for that. And again, I want to wish everybody a very happy and healthy and safe Thanksgiving. Enjoy your friends and family. And if, I know I shouldn't say this, but tune off YouTube, tune out of electronics and spend time with human beings for a change. We can all come back to our devices sometime after the holidays. Thank you so much, folks. I really appreciate it. Everybody stay safe, healthy. I will see you all soon. Take care.